Building automation systems allow a facility to have centralized and automated control of HVAC and other equipment. Control Basic is the coding process that creates automation and flexibility in our controllers running these systems. Previously, we learned how controllers run Control Basic programs, how to set values, how if statements and basic comparisons work, and how we comment our code. In this video, we're going to build on that knowledge and look at more advanced comparisons. Specifically, we're going to work with an interval statement, time on and time off commands, sensor on, sensor off commands, and if plus and if minus commands. Let's start with an interval comparison. Interval is used for comparisons based on a time interval in seconds. This can be useful for logic that you want to run on a periodic basis, such as counters or point passing. Let's look at an example of a counter. Open a new Control Basic program. We're going to start with a rem statement so we know what the program's function is. For this comment, we are going to put up counter. Now, let's start with an interval example. If interval 60, then AV13 equals AV13 plus 1. Breaking this down, we have an if statement with an interval of time. If the interval of 60 seconds goes by, then the analog value 13 will increase by 1. As always, compile and check your code for errors. Now let's write this code slightly differently. If interval equals 1 minute, then AV13 equals AV13 plus 1. The difference between these two styles is how we've indicated time. In this example, we've used hours, minutes, and seconds to indicate a time interval, showing the interval as 1 minute. Both of these examples will operate in the same manner. A great resource that will help you as you're learning the syntax of Control Basic is the Help menu. Here, type keywords into the search box. This will give you a list of all the operators and keywords that you'll be using in your code. Looking at interval, we see a definition of the keyword, an example of how time is used, and how to call it out correctly. Now we're going to move on to writing code using the time on and time off keywords while making a basic comparison. This will allow us to control a point based on how long an input or an output has been on or off. If time on B01 is greater than 20 seconds, then A07 equals 25. This statement says if binary output 1 is on for more than 20 seconds, then the analog output will change to a value of 25. We can also change this statement to time off. It now reads, if binary output 1 is off for greater than 20 seconds, then the analog output will change to a value of 25. Again, compile your code and check for errors. If you are ready to save this code and run it, click Run. The next pair of commands that are useful in comparisons are sensor on and sensor off. The sensor on command looks for a short circuit, such as a push button shorting a thermistor or a contact closure. The sensor off command looks for an open circuit, such as a sensor that has become disconnected. Let's look at an example and see how the if statement may have to change to use these commands better. Here we have written some code to look through. This code says, if the sensor connected to analog input 3 is shorted, then our local variable A will increase by the value of 1. Then we have a few short lines of code to set conditions based on the value of A. As the button is pressed, we will increment from 0 to 3. If A becomes greater than 3, we'll set it back to 0. Binary outputs 1 through 3 will be active depending on the value of A. Now, even though our code has been written with the proper syntax and has compiled, we have a problem. With the standard if statement on this code, A will increase every Control Basic scan when AI3 is shorted. This could be several scans for the duration of the button press, yielding strange behavior if looking for the binary outputs to work properly. This condition can be solved by using an if plus statement. The if plus condition looks for the first time a condition is true and will wait until the condition is false and then true again before increasing our variable. Let's walk through the code with the if plus statement in place. Let's assume A equals 1 and analog input 3 is shorted. The first time the condition is true, it will increment A to 2, binary output 1 and 3 will be off, and binary output 2 will be on. On the next scan, if the button is still pressed, the if plus statement will keep A from being executed until the sensor on command sees the button released for at least one scan. After the button is released and the sensor on command returns false, subsequent button presses will allow A to be incremented as expected. This very small change can make a big difference in how the program operates. For more information on Control Basic and point passing, check out the other videos in this series, or to learn more about any of the solutions from the Building Geniuses at KMC, visit us on the web at kmccontrols.com.